How many members are in the US Senate? I was going to just say 100 but had to tell a story. First, the answer is 100. The more detailed answer would be 2 senators per state. There are 50 states, thus 100 members. It could be more if there is a new state, or less members in the unlikely event that states are combined with their consent, but it is currently 100 members. One might rush to say 101 because of the vice president. Not so fast. The vice president presides over the Senate, but does not participate in debates, except in a tie-breaking vote. The tie-breaking vote authority comes from the Constitution. The language is negative, shall have no vote, except in the event of a tie. The vice president is a welcome, sometimes, and constitutionally protected visitor to the body, but not a member. Throughout history, little attempts to infringe on membership have been fought vigorously. How little power the VP has within the Senate is evidenced by this little story, involving Nixon's VP, for a time, Spiro Agnew. From the Senate website, Spiro Agnew was determined to make the most of that role and to expand his legislative functions as well. Since he lacked previous legislative experience, he had the Senate parliamentarian tutor him on the intricacies of Senate floor procedure. Soon he began to inject himself into the course of Senate proceedings, contrary to the well-worn practice that constrained his predecessors. During the debate over the anti-ballistic missile treaty, Agnew approached Idaho Republican Senator Len Jordan and asked how he was going to vote. "You can't tell me how to vote," said the shocked senator. "You can't twist my arm." He did stop. At the next regular luncheon of Republican senators, Jordan accused Agnew of violating the separation of powers by lobbying on the Senate floor, and announced the Jordan rule. Under his rule, if the vice president tried to lobby him on anything, the senator would automatically vote the other way. Agnew concluded from this experience, "After trying for a while to get along with the Senate, I decided I would go down to the other end of Pennsylvania Avenue and try playing the executive game." Agnew hinted at a significant part of the issue of membership. Because the VP can also perform executive duties, he or she can just not be a member along with other senators. Not the only time a VP got spanked by the Senate and informed that they are really not in the club, only a constitutional officer. Lyndon Johnson, John Adams, Henry Wallace, Charles Dawes are among the vice presidents rebuked by senators for stepping over the line. Now yes, the vice president is admitted to the floor of the Senate, but that comes from both his legislative role and his executive role. As Rule 23 also permits the president, the justices of the Supreme Court, ex-speakers of the House, and several others to the Senate. Yes, as a side diversion, again the answer to the question is 100. Check out Spiro Agnew's bust in the Senate chamber. Yes, everyone gets one, even if they have to resign.